guess I came up from nothing. Had a lot of people who told me that I wouldn't amount to nothing. Soon as I got something started, niggas act like I own something. But nigga, I don't owe you shit. Say I do, fuck you and who you with. I fought for everything I got, and a nigga don't brag about what he have. But I work hard to have a lot, cause I can't go back to a time got bad. Hard nights in my small life is what keep me motivated. But I feel so misunderstood, cause anytime shit go good, they say I'm Hollywood. Cause a young nigga living good. I don't work my way to the top, cause you know the granny don't stop.
So man, like, what's your goal in the next 5 years? Where you trying to be at in life? You know what I'm saying? Like, everybody, like, nowadays, you know, people don't plan their goals and they don't see they don't look to the future. They always look for now. You know what I'm saying? And that's short. You know what I'm saying? That's short-term goals. What's your long-term goals? 5 years. Where you trying to be at?
Man, 5 years, man. I wanna have the company, man, up 100% running. You know, like, my goals are have it as big as Bad Boy. I mean, not with that prestige of the time that they put in.
Right.
But to have that stability where I can go anywhere, man.
Right.
The artist on this label is getting anywhere between 20 and 50K.
Wow.
Show money. Show money was gonna pay him, not the city money.
Right.
And financial stability for myself, my family, my kids, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
So, you know, that's my goal, man. You know, 5 years. I feel like in 5 years, man, we should be.
She's stable doing what we doing, what you're doing.
Yeah, man, yeah. That's my goal, man.
And how long you been in this? When did this vision of you doing what you're doing come apart? You know what I'm saying? When did it hit you?
Man, like, so December 2013.
Right.
I got a friend named AJ Stewart. I call him Juice. Out of the blue, I haven't talked to him since I was like 19, something like that.
Right.
Anyway,
right.
He calls me out the blue. I don't even know how he got my number. 5:36 in the morning, something like that. And he's like, "Hey, man. Mesiah, what's up, man? This is Aaron, man. Blah blah." I'm like, but I remember I'm asleep though. I'm like, who it is? So man, you like, yeah, man, you know, man, I just wanted to tell you, you know, man, I got this meeting with Universal or Atlanta Records in New York.
Right.
One on one. And I got this group with these artists I wanna take. And I was like, well, okay, you know, so that's what's up, man. But I really couldn't remember who he was at the time. I was asleep.
Right.
So he's like, yeah, man. He's asked me, he said, man, I just want you to come in with me and help me establish my company, whatever. I was like, well, I'll tell you what. You go to New York, and when you come back, if it happens, whatever, you know, if they give you some good feedback, whatever, I'll roll with you when you do that.
Right.
So he go up there, whatever. It don't pan out. So he asked me about his people, and I said, man, I don't really think they got it. You know what I'm saying? I don't think they got what it take. Anyway, short story. They break up, all that stuff happens. So December rolls around, then comes January. And I'm like, you know what? I can do this. I want to do my own label. In Bee County, Brazoria County, is so much talent. And I'm like, all I could see was a vision. Now, I've never done this in my life. You know, I've had clubs, barbershops. I'm a street hustler, man. I've been in the streets all my life, man. Since I was on my own since 15. So I'm like, shit, man, this is what it is. I always loved it. I loved entertainment. I love music. I'm like, shit. I used to rap. I was signed to a label.
Wow.
They didn't do shit for me. I did it for myself, man. So it's like, man, let me see what I can do. So I came up with something serious musical. Because I used to do something serious anyway.
Right.
Something serious entertainment was my thing. So I had a DBA for that and everything. So like, all right, my barbershop, I'm gonna do this. So anyway, I hit up a couple of artists. There's a couple that chose not to rock with me. You know, they ain't want, you know, they feel like they need to fuck with me. Like, nah, this and that, blah, blah, blah. Okay, that's cool. So then I rocked, you know, the ones I had came in. I originally started with was Mac Digg, Leah Sky, Fireboy Young. And Leah, you know, I told her, I said, well, you know, she did a couple songs with Mac, two songs. I was like, look, I want you to, I want to pursue you in a modeling situation because she's beautiful. And I was like, I think that'd be a good way for you to get yourself a name out there. And then we can move forward on other stuff, you know, but your name would be solid. You got a name. So it's like, yeah, yeah. She took off, you know what I'm saying? Like, we took off. There's a lot of grit and some BS that went into it and everything else, but like, she took off, you know what I'm saying? So anyway, you know, that's how it started, though, man. A phone call at 5:30 in the morning for somebody I ain't talked to since I was like 19, 18, 19, something like that.
This is what keeps me motivated, but I feel so misunderstood. Cause anytime shit go good, they say I'm Hollywood. Cause a young nigga living good.